The various modes of e-banking includes ATMs, cash depositing machines, internet banking, telebanking, credit and debit card, CFD, mobile banking, then and so on. So let us briefly see into each of these modes of e-banking. The first one is ATM or automated teller machines. I hope you are well aware of what an ATM is. Any person who has an ATM card, that is, say, a debit card or credit card, can go to any ATM and then swipe his card, then give an input the PIN, and then you can do a lot of banking transactions. So, what are the benefits of an ATM? As you know, it is a 24/7 service. Whenever you wish to get money, you can approach an ATM, and there is no time limit for that. Then you will get have a quick and speedy service. That is, whenever you take money from that, this particular amount will be debited from your account, and it will be instantly shown in your balance. Then the customers himself can operate. Then it is free from human errors because we are directly dealing it through online. That is the use of technology. And the banking facilities is available even in places where there are no branches. So yeah, it will be a bit expensive for any bank to build a branch in a particular location or say a remote area, but it is much more easier for a bank to build an ATM center there. So this can help us to withdraw money anytime as we please, and also we can go for checking out our balance, we can take a mini statement, and also all such things. Then we don't need to wait in long queues to get money. Then also the accounts are updated immediately. It reduces excessive pressure on the bank staff because many of them can do their functions on their own, and so the need not the bank staff bother about it. Then also there is privacy of transactions. That is, you know your balance, you can withdraw money, no one else is seeing that. So you have privacy, and also it attracts more and more customers because this ATM service makes banking much, much more easier. Then next one is CDMs or cash depositing machines. That is, that's almost similar to an ATM. That is, a CDM also looks almost similar to an ATM. Here, what we do is you insert your debit or credit card, then you enter your PIN, and then you will have an option wherein you can select deposit, and then the chest will open. You can put your money inside, and then it will count automatically, then and so on. That is, it will be reflected in your account. So again, ATM is for withdrawing money and CDM is for depositing money. So you can withdraw money anytime, anywhere, wherever an ATM is there. And also, if you have a CDM, you can also deposit money anytime. Again, it is also a 24 into 7 service. You don't have to wait in long queues to deposit your money. There is no slips to be filled in. Then the amount is instantly credited into your account. That is, if you are going to a bank to deposit your money, you can see that it will take a little bit of delay, right? It will take up to 2 to 3 hours, maybe. So if you are going towards the end of a banking time, then it may be reflected the next day only, and so on. But all these worries are not there in a CDM. That is, you will get your amount instantly credited into your account at the very moment you deposit your money. And also, you need not arrange your cash on the basis of denomination. If you are going to a branch, you will be asked to arrange your cash on the basis of your denomination. But in CDM, you don't need to do that. You just put the money in there. Then there are no extra charges for depositing your money. CDMs accepts currency notes of denominations of only 100, 500, and 2000. As you know, 200 rupee notes are there, but it is not accepted in a CDM. So you can deposit only 100 rupee, 500 rupee, and 2000 rupee notes. And the minimum amount that you can deposit is 100 rupees, and the maximum amount is 49,900 rupees. That is above 50,000 rupees if you are depositing 50,000 and above. If you are depositing money into an account, then you will have to fetch your PAN card to the banker. So since there is a rule like that, you cannot deposit any amount more than 49,900 rupees through a CDM. And also you can change PIN, you can take mini statements and so on in using CDM. Now, how do we deposit money using CDM? That is explained over here. So just like ATM, insert your debit card, enter your PIN, then select the type of account, that is your savings account, current account, whatever may be. Select it, then the deposit slot will open. Deposit the you can deposit the money straight away into that slot. Then you press continue. The machine will sort all the currency and display the total amount. If you're right about if this amount, that is the total that is shown, is correct, then you can press continue or confirm, so that then confirm the amount and then press the deposit button, and then the machine will print a slip that is with updated balance. So you can use it as a proof that you have deposited your money, and at the very instance your account will be credited and the balance will be shown in your account also. And if any person who does not have an ATM card or who wants some other mode of depositing money through CDM, you can also use your registered mobile number and the account number, right? So if you select without a debit card mode, then you can select your mobile, I mean press your phone number, and then press your account number, then also you can deposit money into a CDM. So again, if you have your relative somewhere else and if you wish to deposit money for them, then if you know their registered mobile number and their account number, then also you can deposit money for them also through a CDM. Then the various modes of home banking, that is, home banking includes internet banking, telephone banking and mobile banking. I am sure that all of you will be well aware of all these things, that is internet banking, telephone banking and mobile banking. So what is an internet banking? That is banking transactions done through the with the use help of internet, right? So you will have an account in there wherein you will be entering your login ID and password, and then you can enter into the account, and then you can do a lot of transactions. So internet banking functions can be divided into transactional account and non-transactional account. That is, only if you have a transactional internet banking account can you do any fund based transactions. So if you want to transfer money from one account to another account, then you need a transactional internet banking account. So if you are having only a non-transactional account, then you can do only your non-fund-based transactions. That is, you can check your balance, you can apply for a new check, you can apply for a new credit card or debit card and so on. All these functions will be available, but you cannot transfer fund through using your internet banking facility. That is the meaning of transactional and non-transactional internet banking systems. Then, yeah, internet banking. As you know, it also uses internet, then it is very quick and efficient. That is, you can do it anywhere, anytime. Banking is the facility for internet banking. If you have internet facility, then you can approach your bank wherever you are. So this internet banking again helps in improving your customer base, because if you were going for the old conventional banking, then this geographical location was a barrier. That is, if you have a bank account in some place far away, then each time you'll have to travel to that particular place for having your banking transactions. Now it's made so easy. That is, you don't need your bank near anyway, because only for certain things or very minute things you will have to a small number of activities need to be done directly by going through the bank. All other transactions are available through internet. So geographical location is not a barrier anymore. You can expand your customer base. So a branch at Kalur, Kuchin, can have their customers अराउंड एर्नाकुलम और इवन एर्नाकुलम डिस्ट्रिक्ट और अराउंड केरला. इट्स ओके, इट्स फाइन बिकॉज एवरी कस्टमर कैन एक्सेस द बैंकिंग फैसिलिटीज थ्रू इंटरनेट. देन ऑल्सो इट हैज इंटरनेट बैंकिंग हैज बिल्ट इन सिक्योरिटी फीचर्स लाइक यू विल हैव टू एंटर योर पिन नंबर देन योर रजिस्टर्ड मोबाइल नंबर एंड सो ऑन इन ऑर्डर टू एक्सेस दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग. So there are a lot of security features inbuilt so that you need not worry whether you will be in trouble by using internet banking. Also, you will have encryption facilities. Then you will have a prescription on the maximum monetary limits and authorizations that can be done through internet banking. All these facilities are there so in order to make your banking transactions secure. Then also you can retrieve any information in a speedy manner using internet banking. If you want to know the interest rate of your loans, then if you wish to know how much amount has been paid, no need, you now don't need to go to the bank. Instead, you can access your internet banking account and then every details will be there. Also, it eliminates the use of costly papers. There are no more papers and bundling up of papers or storing a lot of papers for keeping the records. Everything is available online, so its retrieval is also easy and its storage is also easy and even less time consuming compared to the olden traditional methods. Then also it's all services are available at convenience. That is, wherever you are, it is there in front of you. You need not go to the bank if you have internet banking. Instead, the bank will come to you. That is the type of service that that they provide in internet banking, and also it attracts more customers. That is, all the bankers are having a healthy competition due to the internet banking facilities provided because everyone is there in the market. There is no geographical boundaries or any other issues. The only thing they can do is by giving more and more or better and better services to its customers. So every person will try to have more user-friendly accounts or internet banking services so that they can attract more and more customers. Any person who provides best services or any person who provides more and more user-friendly accounts for your internet banking can attract more customers. These are the features of internet banking. Then moving to the factors responsible for the growth of internet banking. The first one is competition. That is, there is high competition as we already said. There is no geographical boundary, so the competition has improved very high. Then cost efficiency is a major reason. You need not have to waste your money or energy on the bundling of papers. Instead, it is very cost effective, and also you need less number of staff, and even the staff can reduce all their burdens, and so it has a lot of cost efficiency. Then it will have a wider reach because there is no geographical boundaries. Then also relationship marketing. That is, now the Even though you can, the banker and the customer don't see one to one in through bank because of the use of internet banking, still we can go for building our customer relationship, which is a prerequisite in internet banking. And also again, you have round-the-clock access whenever you want, wherever you want, anytime it is available. And so this is a main feature because everyone can save a lot of time. And so these are the factors that is responsible for the growth of internet banking.